Aloha and welcome to the Bear Wozniak Adventure. I'm stoked to have as my guest today, Jesse Romero. We'll be getting to him in a little bit. But I want to talk today about bullying. The whole thing about bullying that we're seeing in our society today. Men are being bullied just for being manly. You can't be a man anymore. And I think some of you heard the story last week. I finally called out this bully out in the water. He's been bullying people at this beautiful surf spot called Queens for over 20 years. I've had to back him down a couple of times. And finally, last Sunday, I thought, you know what? If he's out there, Lord, I'm going to deal with him.
Welcome to the Bear Wozniak Adventure. Kickstart that engine and roll thunder with the pack. Explore the grittiness of manly spirituality. Gain traction in the virtues. Soup up your spiritual engine by turning adversity into adventure. Now here's Bear Wozniak. Let's ride.
Monsignor Joseph Essef, Scranton, Pennsylvania, oldest exorcist in the U.S., teaches at Mundelein Seminary, says if you live in a state of grace, you're protected from the diabolical. Father Paolo Carnin, current exorcist right now in the Vatican, says if you live in a state of grace, you're protected.
What's a state of grace?
There you go. Bingo. That's the key operative word. That's why I wrote this book right here. See that? That's why I wrote this book.
What's it called? The Lord.
How to live in a state of grace.
Lord, what does it say, Trent? Lord, train.
Lord, prepare my hands for battle. Psalm 14.
By thee I can crush a troop. By thee I can leap a wall. By thee I can bend a bow of bronze. Lead me to the rock too high to climb, and I will climb it. The thing about it is when we're with the Lord, you think about it. You're just a little guy fighting Goliath, but behind you is standing the whole army of God.
That's right.
So what does it mean to live in a state of grace?
To live in a state of grace, biblically, it means to live in friendship with God. To be a friend of God is to live in a state of grace. And the biblical basis for that would be James chapter 2, verse 23, James chapter 4, verse 4, James chapter 15, verses 13 to 15. If you're a friend of God, you're in a state of grace.
First, talk to us about what it means to be oppressed, obsessed, possessed, the different areas like that. And then what our role can be. We're probably going to run out of time in this segment before we get to it. When you smell a rat, and that's the way you kind of discern a demon, you almost smell them. You smell a rat. Something's not right with this person. How do you deal with it? So tell us, first of all, what is the different levels that we deal with?
There's two ways that demons attack human beings. Here it is. It's called the ordinary activity. And the second's called the extraordinary activity. So there's two levels of attacks by the diabolical. The first level of attack is called the ordinary activity of a demon is called temptation and suggestion. Temptation and suggestion. That's their basic day-to-day operations. Now you have a more acute level of attack by the diabolical. It's called house infestation. And this is big right now on television where the whole...
Hey man, I don't want you to miss out on your free stuff at deepadventure.com. Go there and subscribe to our weekly email newsletter. You get free video content, including the Bear Wozniak radio show, video version on YouTube before it even airs on EWTN. And you can follow us on all of our social media. Go to deepadventure.com and subscribe. Get your free stuff. And if you're watching on YouTube, don't forget to press the subscribe button and ring that little bell. Don't miss out.